Come in. You're just right on time. Come on, I want to show you what just arrived here. Your beautiful flowers.
I didn't know about the color.
Oh, the color is... it's beautiful. I love it.
If you don't mind me saying, your outfit's giving the flowers quite a run for the money.
Really? Thank you. Actually, I'm just a little bit embarrassed. The outfit that I had planned to wear, well, it had a stain on it, so I kind of threw this one together.
I was late as well, but I didn't pull it off as well as you did.
I'm not so sure about that. Actually, if you just maybe loosen your tie a little bit, button that button. First time I've been out to dinner alone with a man since Todd died.
This is upsetting you.
No, I'm fine, really. It must be the first time for you too, huh? Since Marty's wedding.
However hard that may be.
Two old memories.
Mrs. Manning, I really think I ought to take you home. We'll have dinner some other night.
No, I'm fine, really. But will you do me one big favor, please?
Of course.
Please call me Blair.
Blair it is.
Thank you. So, what are you going to order? Looks pretty good tonight. Oh, poor Cord. It must have been a grim sight seeing all the destruction at the Buchanan oil refinery. Will you excuse me, Patrick? Just a moment. Excuse me.
I just think the best thing for you would be to tell me what happened in Galveston. I know it was terrible. Do you know what caused the fire?
No. Hello, Cord. I'm really, sorry. Hello, Tina. I'm really sorry about what happened at the oil refinery.
Yeah, I'm sure you are.
No, I am, but like Tina, I am curious. What really caused the fire? You know what? I would love it if maybe the son could do an exclusive with you and you could tell us the truth about what happened.
Oh, you want the truth?
Yeah.
The Buchanan side of the story.
Absolutely.
Oh, Daryl. Don't utter one word to this harpy, not one damn word.
The dead and almost caused a fatal coronary a few years ago. But this time it ain't gonna be so easy.
You know what, AC? You always take everything so personal. I just print the news as it happens. And speaking of, now what happened to you? You didn't have this sling on your arm the last time I saw you, Cord.
He fell in
the handbell, Cord.
Well, I guess the Buchanans can't get their story straight either on that. So tell me, what about the fire and what happened in Galveston and what are you going to do about it?
You disgusting excuse for a human being.
Oh, come on, Ace.
I'm sorry for interrupting. You did promise me a dance. This is my favorite song, so maybe.
Oh, well, excuse me.
Excuse us.
I hate that woman.
Forget her.
When he sees tomorrow's edition of The Sun.
Is that why you wanted to come out tonight? And the gloat of the Buchanans.
No. I came out this evening because I want to enjoy myself with a very attractive man. So,
We in, please?
Somewhere else if you want.
No. No, we're here and I would like to dance.
Dancing is what we'll do.
Love songs never out of date. Hearts full of passion.
Come on, Ptrick, let's go someplace a little more quiet, less crowded.
Right, let me just pay for the check.
No, Mio, I took care of it. For this on my tab, I'm taking you to dinner. What? Can I get you anything? Maybe a drink?
No, I should be going home now.
Ptrick.
Hmm?
You know, we were having a nice time before Marty and Dylan showed up. Does just seeing her turn you inside out still? Listen, please stay and have a nightcap with me. There's some wine in my kitchen, and I've got to get this phone. Would you please?
All right. Novel right.
Rich, I want it on the front page, and... What? No, I want it right next to Carlo Hessers' good deeds, okay? Thank you. Just do it. Gosh.
Doing this?
Well, it's just the news.
It's not the news. It sounds more like a personal vendetta against Asa Buchanan and his company.
Oh, come on, Ptrick. You think that I pick the news according to my personal feelings? Come on. And you shouldn't give Asa Buchanan too much of the benefit of the doubt, all right? He may look like some good old colorful American patriarch with a big old colorful family full of big old colorful good doers. But I'll tell you about Asa Buchanan. He's a very vengeful, spiteful old man who only cares about himself and his heirs and don't ever, ever mistake him for anything else.
What has he done to earn such wrath from you?
Well, you really want to know? Because I'll tell you.
I want to know.
I was married to him. He was my husband.
Beau's da?
Yeah. Beau's old man. I was young and poor. And I had a mother in a state mental institution. And I had to get her out of that snake pit and into St. Anne's home. I couldn't let her go back to that awful, horrible state mental ward. I was alone and I was desperate. And I had no one else to turn to for the help that I needed. So yeah, I married Asa. And I admit it, I married him for his money. But let me tell you something, he got something out of it too. He got a pretty young wife. He bought me. He saw how vulnerable I was, and he bought me. Well, he went beyond using me. He abused me. He figured, well, hey, he bought the package, and if he didn't get what he paid for, he would take it by force. So is that reason enough to hate that old man? That I wasn't Marty Saybrook, born with a silver spoon in my mouth?
I never meant to compare you.